I'm Jasmine, and as part of our Azure AD architecture series, we're here to talk about header-based authentication app access with Azure AD App Proxy. In case you haven't already seen our other videos, Ramiro walked us through the fundamentals of App Proxy, and Carissa walked us through how to connect your SAML apps with App Proxy. You can go to aka.ms/identity-arc-videos to check these out. Azure AD App Proxy provides remote access to on-prem applications or apps hosted on your private network, so your users can access them the same way they would access their SaaS apps. Today, we're going to see how it works when the app uses headers for authentication. To set the stage, we have Kim, who will access PeopleSoft, which sits on the Corp network and uses header-based authentication. The PeopleSoft app has already been onboarded with Azure AD App Proxy for pre-authentication, which is covered in more depth in the App Proxy Fundamentals video. With pre-authentication, this means users will be asked to authenticate before accessing the app so that only authenticated traffic reaches the on-premises server. In addition to enabling pre-auth, this app is also set up for single sign-on for header-based authentication. During single sign-on setup, the specific headers the application needed were configured. Any attribute synced to Azure AD will be available to configure as a header value. Now let's walk through how access will look for a header-based auth app. In step one, Kim goes to the URL that she bookmarked for the PeopleSoft application. And under the covers, DNS is pointing to the App Proxy cloud service. With App Proxy, we can use the same internal and external URL, so users don't have to remember two separate URLs when coming from inside or outside the corporate network. In step two, the App Proxy cloud service uses the original URL of the HTTP request to check the core store to find the app configuration to know what to do for the rest of the flow. In this case, it has configuration for header-based auth. Once it has the information it needs, the App Proxy cloud service redirects Kim to Azure AD for pre-authentication in step three. Here, auth services implement the OpenID Connect protocol for handling authentication. In step four, authentication services validate Kim's credentials, conditional access policies are evaluated, and the corresponding controls are applied. In step five, authentication services issue Kim a token scoped to App Proxy. This fulfills the pre-authentication process. Now that App Proxy has a valid token for the session, it will next insert the configured headers for the app before continuing to forward the HTTP request to the PeopleSoft app in step six. In this case, the required headers were a department, user ID, and role attribute. These headers will now be part of the request sent down to the app server. In step seven, the App Proxy connectors pick up the request and passes this on to the internal URL, and the app can utilize the headers in the request as needed. Then in step eight, the response is directed back through the cloud service. And lastly, in step nine, App Proxy renders the content back to Kim and she can access PeopleSoft. From this point on, subsequent requests to the app will continue to include the headers. Now that we've talked about how the flow works, let's go ahead and recap. With Azure AD App Proxy, you can publish header-based auth apps and configure which specific attributes to include as headers for the app without changing your applications. App Proxy helps simplify providing remote access to your header-based auth apps, and the apps are not directly exposed to the internet. The connectors on-prem will only use outbound communication to the cloud service to receive and process requests, and pre-authentication should be used whenever possible for security. The internal to external URL for the App Proxy app also determines the scope of what your application's policies will be assigned to. So you can make this as broad as the top-level domain, like peoplesoft.contoso.com, or publish another app with a more granular path, like peoplesoft.contoso.com/profile, with a more granular access policy. App Proxy will always match your policies to the path that is most specific. If you want to learn more about App Proxy, definitely check out our other videos, which walk through the fundamentals of setting up App Proxy in your environment and integrating other types of apps. You can find all these videos and more at aka.ms/identity-arc-videos, which is posted in the description. Thanks for watching.